A warm greetings to everyone. Agriculture Makers in Mission, IBPS AFO welcomes you to this video and happy to see you all again. And in this video, we are going to see the agriculture current affairs for the month of February 2021. And come on, let's get into the video. Very firstly, the Ministry of Tribal Affairs includes 14 new MFP items under MSP scheme to provide fair prices to the tribal gatherers. And MFP stands for minor forest produce, whereas MSP is your minimum support price. Yes, Ministry of Tribal Affairs has included 14 additional MFP items under the MSP scheme to ensure the tribal gatherers to get fair prices for their forest producers. And the 14 items are Tassar Cocoon, Cashew Kernel, Elephant Apple Dry, Bamboo Shoot, Malkangani Seed, Mahul Leaves, Nagod, Kogru, Pipla, Gamari, Oroxyluminidism, Wild Mushroom, and then Shringraj and Tree Moss. And the 14 items have been added to MSP under the mechanism of marketing of minor forest produce through MSP and development of value chain for MFP scheme. Secondly, the World Wetland Day is celebrated on 2nd February every year. World Wetlands Day is annually observed across the globe on 2nd February to create awareness about the importance of wetlands and their roles toward humans and planet. And in 2021, it is the 25th World Wetlands Day, and the theme is wetlands and water. The theme is very much important. And next, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare gets DGCA nod for a first of its kind pilot study using drones to capture crop images in 100 districts under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Let's go in detail. Director General of Civil Aviation gave approval to the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare to use drones to capture images of rice and wheat in 100 districts to assess the crop yields at Gram Panchayat level under the PMFBY, Government of India's Crop Insurance Scheme. This is the first time in India that remote sensing technology based largest pilot study is conducted for crop yield estimation. Remember the crop. And next, India's tea output drops 9.7% in 2020 due to flood and COVID restriction, but it lifts the average prices to record high. The production of tea in India has been dropped by 9.7% in 2020 due to flood and COVID-19 pandemic. The reduction in tea production increased the price of tea by 31% from the price of 2019 to a record price of 184.69 per kg. The increase in price has supported the Indian tea industry, which was under severe stress due to the rising production cost. Okay. India has produced around 1255.60 million kg of tea in 2020, which is around 9.7% lesser than the production in 2019. The tea export of India during the first 11 months of 2020 has fallen to 18.2% from the previous year, which is 187.92 million kg. And about the Tea Board of India, the chairman is Prabhat Kamal Besbora and the headquarters is in Kolkata, West Bengal. Next, Textile Minister Mrs. Smriti Irani virtually inaugurates 8th India International Silk Fair. Let's go in detail. Union Minister for Women and Child Development and Textiles, Mrs. Smriti Zubin Irani, virtually addressed the inaugural session of India's biggest silk fair, the 8th India International Silk Fair. Okay. The 5-day long event was virtually organized by Indian Silk Export Promotion Council, a non-profit organization under the Ministry of Textiles and sponsored by the Department of Commerce. And about silk, India is the only country in the world to produce all the 4 varieties of silk, that is mulberry, eri, tassar and muga. Actually, it is very important to study all those scientific names, because last time in the AFO examination, they have asked the scientific name of this tropical tassar. So you have to read all those things. And coming to the point, India, it is second place in the silk production after China. India has around 11 GI in silk, including Pochampalli Ikat, Chandarpal silk, Mysore silk, Kanjipuram silk, Muga silk, Salem silk, Arani silk and Champa silk. China is the world's largest producer and exporter of silk. And about the Ministry of Textiles, the Union Minister is Smriti Zubin Irani and the Minister of State, it is Ajay Tamta. Very nextly, a target of ₹16.5 lakh crore for ground level credit to agriculture has been fixed for the year 2021 to 2022. And as government has fixed the target of ₹16.5 lakh crore for ground level credit GLC for agriculture in the year 2021 to 2022, it is an increase of 10% over the previous year, which is ₹15 lakh crore. The target has been fixed considering the performance under GLC flow during 2013-14 to 2020-21. The target, among others, was mentioned in the Union Budget 2021-2022 by the Finance Minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman, while making announcement for the agri sector. Nextly, Manipur CM Mr. N. Byron Singh launched a new range of packaged organic products and Laumi Connect app to help the farmers. Yes, Manipur CM launched a new range of packaged organic products and Laumi Connect app under Manipur Organic Mission Agency and the Mission Organic Value Chain Development for Northeastern Region. These were launched in a function organized jointly by Directorate of Horticulture and Soil Conservation and Eastern Border Areas Development Authority at the CM Secretariat, Manipur. Government appoints expert committee headed by T.P. Rajendran to review the proposal to ban 27 pesticides. The government has appointed an expert panel to review the objection of industry to the proposed ban on 27 pesticides that are mentioned as harmful to animals and as humans. The committee is headed by T.P. Rajendran, who is the former Assistant Director General of ICAR. These 27 pesticides that are widely used are part of 66 contentious pesticides that are being reviewed for their toxicity. Already in 2018, the government had banned 18 of them. The 27 pesticides comprise 12 insecticides, 8 fungicides and 7 herbicides involving 130 formulations. And the list includes 2,4-D, acephate, atrazine, benfuracar, butaclar, captan. I think they have included all the chemicals that are used in the agriculture field. Next, carbendazim, carbofuran, chlorpyrifos, deltamethrin, dicofol, dimethoate, dinocap, diuron, malathion. Usually they say that malathion is one of the safest chemicals that can be used in vegetables, but they have also included this in the list. Then mancozeb, methimyl, monocrotopaz, oxyfluorphen, pendimethalin, quinalfas, sulfosulfuron, thiodicarb, thiophenate methyl, thyrum, zinab and xerum. And nextly, Government of India allocates rupees 16,000 crore for PMFBY for financial year 2021 to 2022, and then it is an increase of around 305 crore as compared to the financial year 2021. The reason behind an increase in the amount is to boost the safety of farmers' crops and ensure maximum benefit. Notably, the scheme covers the entire cropping cycle from pre-sowing to post-harvest, which include loss coverage due to prevented sowing and mid-season adversities. Nextly, FAO endorses first ever declaration for sustainable fisheries and aquaculture at COFI 34. Yes. During the 34th session of UN's FAO Committee on Fisheries, which took place virtually from Feb 1 to Feb 5, 2021, members of the session supported the first ever declaration for sustainable fisheries and aquaculture. The declaration calls for the strong action to combat illegal, unreported and unregulated fishing and emphasized on the importance of recovering from the impacts of COVID-19 pandemic. The report, The Impact of COVID-19 on Fisheries and Aquaculture Food Systems, Possible Responses, released by FAO in November 2020, was discussed during the COFI 34 session. Due to the pandemic, the global aquaculture production is expected to fall by around 1.3%, which is the first fall in several years. The next COFI session, that is COFI 35, is said to be held from September 5 to 9 in 2022. Coming to the COFI, the Committee on Fisheries is a subsidiary body of FAO Council, established by the FAO Conference in 1965, and it is the only intergovernmental forum where the members of FAO discuss and review issues related to fisheries and aquaculture. And about FAO, the Director General is Q. Dongyu and the headquarters is in Rome, Italy. Next, World Pulses Day is celebrated on 10th of February. In detail, the UN's World Pulses Day is annually observed on 10th February to celebrate the contribution of pulses to the sustainable food system, healthy growth and environmental benefits. First World Pulses Day was celebrated on 10th February 2019 and the United Nations General Assembly adopted the resolution on 20th December 2018 and proclaimed that 10th February of every year as the World Pulses Day, and it was proposed by Burkina Faso. National Horticulture Fair held in Bangalore, co-organized by ICAR IAHR, and it is inaugurated by Kailash Chowdhury. A 5 days long National Horticulture Fair was held on February 8 to 12, 2021 at Hisar Ghatta, Bangalore, on the theme Horticulture for Startup and Stand-up India. It was organized by IAHR in collaboration with ICAR ATARI, Atari, Bangalore, Society for Promotion of Horticulture, Bangalore, and Besset Hort Technology Business Incubator, ICAR IAHR, Bangalore, Sri Sri Institute of Agricultural Sciences and Technology Trust, Bangalore, and National Horticulture Board, which is in Gurugram, Haryana. The fair was held both in physical and virtual formats for the first time. The virtual event was inaugurated by the Minister of State, Mr. Kailash Chowdhury. and it showcased cutting-edge technologies, crop varieties, pest and disease management practices, and processing methods, among others. Next, NEGPA, the mission of digital agriculture. That is, the National E-Governance Plan in Agriculture is a centrally sponsored scheme initiated in 2010 and 11 as a pilot project in 7 states, Assam, HP, Jharkhand, Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra and MP. It was then extended to the remaining states and the 2 union territories in 2014-15 for a period of 5 years. Now, this 5 years period was extended up to March 31st, 2021. The aim of the scheme is to provide timely access to the agriculture-related information to the farmers through information and communication technology. And Smriti Irani virtually inaugurated jute seed distribution plan and jute farmers awareness workshop at Barakpur, West Bengal. Yes, our Union Minister, Mrs. Smriti Zubin Irani, virtually inaugurated the Certified Jute Seeds Distribution Plan and Jute Farmers Awareness Workshop on Improved Cultivation and Advanced Rating Exercise for Jute Initiative. The workshop was organized at ICAR, Central Research Institute for Jute and Allied Fibers Institute at Barakpur, West Bengal. And remember, it is important. Central Research Institute for Jute and Allied Fibers is in Barakpur, West Bengal. Both events are organized by our Ministry of Textiles through its field offices, vice the Office of Jute Commissioner, National Jute Board, that is Jute Corporation of India, and ICAR CRIJAF. Nextly, the book Agriculture Acts 2020, written by former Madras High Court Judge A.K. Rajan, was released. Yes, Dravidar Kazhagam President K. Veeramani released a book Agriculture Acts 2020, which was written by Justice A.K. Rajan, who is the former judge of the Madras High Court. The book is about the 3 controversial central farm laws which resulted in months-long massive protest by farmers in New Delhi. It has shown how the law hit at the federal structure of India. Next, Goa to become India's first fisheries hub with an investment of 400 crores. Union Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Mr. Giriraj Singh, has stated that the central government is set to invest 400 crore in Goa to transform the state into India's first fisheries hub. Of the 400 crore, the Union Minister has already sanctioned 41.7 crore to Goa under Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. And the planned activities includes 30 crore to be allocated for setting up aquarium cluster under ornamental fisheries for generating employment and income. A seaweed complex will also be set up for the same purpose. 50 crore for upgrading the Margao wholesale fish market and 2.5 crore for the construction of marine hatchery. Next, coming to Tamil Nadu CM Mr. Edappadi K. Palaniswamy. Actually, it is the current affair of February month, but now election has been conducted and the CM has been changed. Yes, Tamil Nadu CM Mr. Edappadi K. Palaniswamy inaugurates AIIRLAS, Asia's largest cattle park in Salem. Tamil Nadu CM inaugurated Asia's biggest cattle park, Advanced Institute for Integrated Research on Livestock and Animal Sciences in Thalaivasal of Salem district in Tamil Nadu. It was constructed at a cost of 1023 crore. It is the state's 5th veterinary college. In addition to this, he also inaugurated a veterinary medical college and Thalaivasal Revenue Taluk Office. On the occasion, he has announced that a frozen salmon station will be set up in Karumandurai, Salem at a cost of 100 crore. And then second anniversary of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi has been celebrated on 24th February 2021. It was launched on 24th February 2019 and it is very important. It is launched by our Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi at Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. It is important. It is 100% funded by the central government. The objective of the scheme is to supplement the income of farmer irrespective of the size of their landholdings. The government has allocated 65,000 crore for the scheme in the Union Budget of 2021-22 and it is said to be the highest. Awards has also been given to the best performing states including Karnataka, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. And with this we are concluding and I hope the video will be very much useful to you. Keep supporting us throughout our journey and thank you for all your cooperation and support and please do subscribe our channel. Thank you.